King, rolling, goes deep, the pass, oh, it's caught, it is a completed catch by Courtney Lurk. How did he grab that? He has it, and Houston is still alive. King. Oh boy, Reedy, just what you're talking about. Now he's gonna reverse it back, and King is gonna go in for the touchdown.
Whims for the few, then look at me, took me, shook me, killing me, singing from heartache, from the pain, taking my message from the veins, speaking my lesson from the brain, seeing the beauty through the...
It's gone. USF, your perfect season. It's gone. Like my hair. It's all gone. How's everybody doing this week? Welcome to the Jason Vegas Show. And happy. Happy right now. Gotta feel like we got a leg up on USF now. We're gonna move up. We're gonna be top 15 when the rankings come out today. And USF is gonna be unranked. They are gonna fall after a loss to Houston, as you just saw there. And our Knights are gonna move up after a 73-33 win over the Austin Peay Governors, a school record. 73 points were scored by the Knights tonight. it was really kind of an ugly game, to be honest. It wasn't our best effort defensively, and I think halfway through the game, started to feel like, man, Austin Peay ought to be playing the lottery here in Florida while they're here. Good grief, how many tip balls and near fumbles and near turnovers could end up touchdowns? It happened, was it three times, two or three times? Guys, it wasn't as bad as it looks for the defense. And I think Coach Chenander kind of put a patchwork group out there this week. It wasn't their best effort. I think they would tell you that. But also, you know, not a conference game, not a team we've seen before. And Austin Peay was playing the Super Bowl tonight when we were playing a preseason game. I think you have to take all that into your thought process when you decide how you're going to judge the defense on that one. As far as coach, hopefully coach just throws that film away, says, hey, we won the game. We can give up 33 points and still win by 40. And that's the luxury we have right now, guys. Mackenzie Milton, oh my goodness. Our Hawaiian quarterback, that man is on fire. That kid missed two passes the whole game. Throws three touchdowns, runs for another one. Just a beautiful game out of him. 59 points through the third quarter. The team hits over 50 again, over 70 for the first time this year. And like I said, school record, 73 points. Snelson with an amazing catch right there before halftime. Gets the one foot in bounds, even though nobody saw it. I guess except for me. Live, but yeah. An amazing game for the offense. Just looks solid. Killens did play in the beginning. They put him down. Let him get some rest. Otis Anderson was a little banged up from the Navy game. They let him go ahead and rest. Conference play, obviously, guys, way more important than anything that was going to happen tonight. Don't think that the victory was ever in doubt in anyone's mind. Just a real impressive outing from our team. And it feels really good right now. 7-0. One of only five undefeated teams left in the whole country. University of Miami is the only other one here in the state of Florida. Georgia still undefeated. Penn State falls from the ranks of the undefeated today with the loss to Ohio State. Now they're both one-loss teams. And teams we're going to have to watch, if they get their second loss, those are teams we might jump in front of. We're trying to get in the mix for the playoff. And a lot of doubters out there, a lot of people hating on UCF, a team that went through a hurricane, an actual natural disaster, and survived it, made it through, didn't play football for 23 days, guys. This team sat out 23 days and went up to Maryland and got a win, followed it up by beating Memphis. I'm sorry, y'all. I am so sorry for you that hate against my team because these kids went through something real. And you can say what you want to say about them. You can say our schedule's soft. That's fine. That's fine. I hear that. I hear that argument. But that's why we're getting the money, guys. That's why Danny White's out there collecting money to pay these coaches. And it's not just that. Football Excellence Fund. This has also got to be for the conference expansion. When it comes, we need to be ready. We got to have the money. We got to be ready to buy ourselves out of the American or whatever else we may have to do. We're not trying to play the schedule that we play now. Not that we're not happy to be in the American, but this team's trying to be great. This program's trying to get to another level. And, you know, there are things holding that down. But when it's ready to happen, you got to be ready. So when you're on Twitter seeing Danny White post about $500,000 donations, $125,000 donations, things like that. He's getting ready. He's getting ready for the big time. And it all starts with keeping this coaching staff in place. Coach Frost doing an amazing job. Chenander, Walters, all of them right down the line, all the way to my boy Coach Becton. He wants to keep these guys. He wants to keep them happy, and he wants to keep them in town. So why, you know, are people saying, oh, your schedule, this and that? And it's like, it's not like we're sitting here being content with who we're playing, okay? We can't control that. But the American's a good conference, all right? Memphis is a great football team. USF is a solid football team. Houston went into USF today and beat them. Another solid football team. There is good football played in the American Conference. There's no reason why this conference can't be included in the Power Six. It should be there. I'm sorry. This is not the MAC. I heard us compared to Western Michigan earlier today, and it really just upset me to hear us compared to a team from the MAC. I'm sorry, no disrespect to the MAC, but we moved up from that. That's where we started. 2002 was our first year in the MAC. We go 7-1, I think, in conference play, if I remember right. And it just really upsets me to hear people hating on this team that is trying to build something great. And this team that has gone 7-0 despite 23 days off. And I can't imagine trying to explain that to somebody, how hard it is to come back and play a football game after just sitting down for 23 days, wondering if you're going to have a home, how your family's doing. You know, like real problems. So I'm going to digress off of this, guys, but that's some real feelings there for you, and I'm sure a lot of people echo that thought. But guys, another great win for the Knights tonight, 73-33. Just a solid effort. Offense couldn't be stopped. The defense is going to have to fix some things, but again, I just don't think we were playing 100% healthy. That was a hard-hitting game we played in last week. So we got to get ready for SMU, who is coming off a win over Tulsa the other night. They had to come back. They were down 10 points. And they are also 6-2. And doing well on the western side of this conference. So it's going to be a challenge. We're going to go there to Dallas. It might be a little cool. It was definitely cool in their game the other night, so we might be facing some cold weather, which some of our kids aren't used to. But I think we're going to go up there and we're going to play very well, and we're gonna move on. And we'll get to that later this week, of course, with the preview video. And, man, guys, 7-0. So here we are, 7-0. To the friendlies watching, 7-0. Gotta feel good right now. And we will see what happens next. We're going to go on to Dallas next week and face SMU that has given us fits in the past. The last time we were perfect in conference, Blake, we went over there to SMU and played in negative temperatures, I think it was, and survived 17-13. So saw Blake was out at the game tonight. I'm sure him and the other guys from the Fiesta Bowl year, they look at what they built and they got to be really, really proud of what they're looking at in the future. The money that's being spent out there at UCF on the baseball complex, all the advances that are being made around the football stadium. Guys, this is the start of something big, and the city of Orlando, to the folks that live there, you guys have got to get on this bandwagon. Now, I know the attendance was a little light tonight, and that's okay. That's all right. FCS team coming in. It wasn't scheduled. It was 100% chance of rain. I get all the excuses tonight. Hey, I stayed down here in Naples because FEMA told me they'd give me $1,000 this weekend for groceries that were lost in the hurricane. So some of us still dealing with real life here. That's completely understood, and I get that. We got to get out there and support this team, guys. The money's got to be spent one way or another. If we want to get an invite to the Big 12, SEC, ACC, we got to be filling up our 46,000 seat stadium every week. So guys, we're gonna wrap this up. So go ahead and make sure to follow me on Twitter at JasonVegas22. Go ahead and like, share, subscribe here on YouTube. And we're going to keep doing this. We're going to keep rolling on. The train's going to keep going forward. It's going to be with or without some of you guys. So let's keep this going in the right direction. And we will check back in this week with a pregame show for the SMU game, which is 7:15 next Saturday, ESPN. 2 on the deuce. So everybody have a great week. Until then, we will see you on the pregame show. Take care, everybody.